Very good morning to all of my dear students. Today I am very happy that I am standing in front of you and communicating with you. Only one girl has come because of COVID, but I am very happy to teach her also. Okay, I am going to take your summer training on using Simulink. I am Dr. Pooja. Today is lecture 4 and we will build a simple model for generation of sine wave. So let's start. Fine. So this is, I have already opened the Simulink editor window. Fine. Now we have to generate a model for sine wave generation. So if we want to add annotation or comment or label, double click here. Now click on create annotation. A rectangular box appears with an insertion pointer. Type generate a sine wave. Now select it if you want to change its font size 18. Okay, now click somewhere on the unoccupied area of the canvas. Now if you want to move this, click on this title and then drag it to the desired location. Okay, to generate a sine wave we need a sine wave block which can be accessed from commonly used block sublibrary or sources library. Okay, now this is our library browser icon which is present on the Simulink tool strip. So single click on it. Okay, this will open up the library browser window. On the left side we can see various categories, various sub libraries where, so if you click on this commonly used blocks, then on the right side you will see all the blocks present in this sub library. So we need a sine wave block. We will look for it. Okay, scroll down. There is no sine wave. Okay, then close it. Oh, sorry. Now click on sources library. So you can see there is a constant block, clock block, okay, ground signal, pulse generator, ramp, random, repeating. So here you can see it's a sine wave block. Now we have to, so when you click on it you will see that you will an information about the functioning of the block gets displayed. So you can see that sine wave outputs a signal which is described by the equation OT is equal to amplitude into sine bracket frequency into T plus phase bracket close plus bias. Okay, now how to drag and drop this sine wave block into the model window so that it can be added to the new model file. So click on it. First of all, position your mouse cursor on it, then click the left mouse button and hold it down. Now drag it onto your model and then release the mouse button. You will see it will get displayed on your canvas. Fine, sine wave. Okay, here also you can fill the amplitude, but if you do not want to fill it here and you want to open up the sine wave block parameter dialog box, and then you click somewhere on the unoccupied area of the block diagram. Now if you want to move this block, position your cursor on this block. Now again click the left mouse button and hold it down and then drag it to the desired position. Now release the left mouse button. Okay, now if you want to resize it, Again, position your mouse cursor on the block. Now you will see square boxes appear at the corner. So now we will drag the corner with the same process. Click the left mouse button and hold it down and then drag the corner. So we can resize the sine wave block. Okay. When you click somewhere outside the area, the name disappears. But when you again click on the block, it's the name of the block again reappears. Okay, fine. Then click somewhere. Okay, now what else we need to view the output waveform? We need a scope block. So click on the library browser and then go to the syncs library. Then you will see display block. If you want to see the result of addition of two constants, okay, if you don't want to see the output waveform, just addition, subtraction of constants, variables, vector quantities, you will use display block. And scope is used to see any signal as a function of time. So the process of dragging and dropping the scope block is also similar as I had just told you. Drag it and drop it onto your model window. Okay, you can change the number of input ports here also. If you do not want to change, then simply click somewhere on the unoccupied area of the block diagram. Now you can move it, select it, and then drag it, and then to resize it, drag the corners. Okay, you can move it to the desired position. Now how to connect these two blocks? Before connecting these blocks, suppose if double click create annotation, generate y is equal to 4 sine pi t. Now change its font size . Select it using the insertion pointer and change its font size. So our target is, if you want to block, move this annotation, you can select it and drag it. So this is our target. We have to generate a sine wave that whose amplitude is, okay, 4, peak value is 4 and angular frequency is pi. So how to configure this block parameters? By default, the sine wave, double click on the sine wave block, the block parameter sine wave block window appears. Now these are the default parameters. Sine type drop down menu. If you want to access this drop down menu, click on this downward arrow. You will get two options. Here we will use time based. Okay. So keep the default settings time based, time, use simulation time. So to define the input variable, the sine block by default use simulation time for the time source. Now change the value of the amplitude. We want amplitude to be 4. So delete it and type 4. Now bias is the constant added to this signal. So we have not added any constant, so keep its default setting and keep it to value 0. Now please see the frequency. Units of frequency are radian per second. So we have to enter here pi, sine pi it is the angular frequency pi pi. Okay, angular frequency is pi is in radians per second. Now, what else? Phase. We have not added any phase to this waveform, so keep its default setting, that is zero. Keep sample time also equal to zero. If we do not get a smooth wave, we will reduce it. Now click apply, and then okay. So this is a scope block. Now we have to connect these two blocks together. Place the mouse onto the output port. You can see that there is no input port on the sine wave block, because which means that by default sine wave will use the simulation time to define this input variable parameter, that is the time signal. Okay, and this 4 is also specified, this pi is also specified in the block diagram parameter window. Now we need to connect these two blocks together. Position the mouse cursor on the output port that is present on the right side of the block. The mouse pointer changes into a cursor. Now again press left mouse button, hold it down and then drag it towards the input port of the scope block. Okay, you see while the mouse is kept down, you will see a dashed line. But when you position the mouse on the input port of the scope block, then a solid line appears. Now release the mouse button. If a solid black line appears with an arrow, then it means that these two blocks are properly connected. Now if you move the block, scope block, by selecting it, you will see that the two blocks are properly connected. The signal lines will reroute themselves and stay properly connected. So we need not to worry about this. We can move our blocks, we can resize them. Okay, fine. Now we have to see the output. By default, the simulation run time is 10. We can change it by clicking on simulation, then model, configuration, parameters. Okay, in this window, keep the start time to be 0. If you want it, the simulation stop time to be 10. If you want to run with the default settings, it's okay. If you want to change it, you can change it. Okay, suppose if I want to make it to 20, you can see that now this apply button becomes highlighted. So now I will click on it, then okay. So all my changes now have been applied to the block diagram. Now I will run this simulation button. This is the shortcut icon, otherwise I can also use this simulation. This is the Simulink editor window menu bar. Click on it and then click on the run button. So these are the shortcut icons on the Simulink tool strip. Click on it left with the left mouse button. Okay, simulation may take some time. Now you will double click on the scope block to see the output. Okay. So as you can see that a smooth waveform does not appear. So what we can do? Simulation, model, configuration, parameter. Sorry, double click on the scope block, sine wave, source block, and change the sample time to 0.001. Apply. Okay. Now rerun the simulation to see the output. Now double click on the scope block. Now you have obtained a smooth sine wave. Fine. Now we can verify it is from 0 to 4. So we can see that its peak value is 4. What should be its time period? We will verify. It should generate this wave. Y is equal to 4 sine pi t. When angular frequency is pi, then time will be equal to, time is equal to 1 upon f. F is equal to omega upon 2 pi. So pi upon 2 pi will be 1 by 2. So time period should be equal to 2 seconds. So aap dekh sakte ho, you can see that the time period is equal to 2 second 0 to 2. So our output wave is correct. Now if you want to change the background of your figure to white, so click on this icon, model, configuration. Then this is the configuration properties icon, this is the style icon, click on it. Now change the figure color background to white. Plot type is line, axis color, so axis color background color white, select it. Then to access this drop down menu, click on this downward arrow, and now here this is for text and labels and grid colors, so select it to be black. Apply. Okay, so we'll get this. Now again open it. Properties for line, sine wave. If you want to change the color of this sine wave, then select line color, choose it 7. If you want to change its width, you can change it. If you want to change its style and make it to be dashed, okay, click apply. Okay. So this wave, I think you can also alternatively right click on this wave and click on this style button. I think thickness is not, doesn't seem to be good, so make it to be 1. Now it's okay. If you want to print this figure, you can click Alt print screen, mouse keyboard with keyboard, and you can have it pasted on a document. Suppose if you want to paste it on a notepad in any document, minimize it. Now press Alt print screen. Alt print screen, and then right now it's not showing the option. Is Alt print screen, sorry, Alt print screen. Print display to figure. Okay. Well, let me tell you how to save this file. Okay. Now click on file, then save as. Now give a name, desired name of your own choice. Suppose say it to be sine. Okay, now go to save as menu. We need to select, we can save it in the latest version. This is the latest version, MATLAB 2019. Save it with an extension .slx save. Would you like to save it? We have to select a location also. Okay. Save it in the desktop. Now this model will get saved on the desktop. We have to provide a proper location for saving your model file. This is your model file. Now if you want to create a new model, then click on this new model icon, and you will see a new model window appears where you can draw a model for any other problem. If you don't want, then you may close it. Okay, then to how to print the output waveform, let me try once again. Double click on the output. I think there is some problem with any of the key. Alt, print screen, or simply I can press print screen. Let's see what happens. Then notepad. The option for pasting doesn't come. Okay. So I will check it and then tell you in the next class what to do. File. Okay. You can also use a file, then copy to clipboard, and now we will see. Okay. There is some problem which I will check and we will try to fix it in the next lecture. Okay. So what else? Saving a file, I have told you, how to run simulation. So if you want to change the name of this block, you can also change it. Just select the block, click on it, and then type in this rectangular window if you wanted to make it capital, and then click somewhere outside the unoccupied area. You can change the name of the block, you can add any annotation, any comment on this editor window. So this is all for today's lecture. In the next lecture, we will draw or build a model for generating integration of sine wave. So you all can look for this task on net, and then I will ask you in the next class how to solve this, how many blocks we will need, and from where to access those blocks. So I will ask these type of questions from you. Thank you so much for today's lecture. Thank you for listening to me patiently.